subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
We're talking about climate today, and more specifically, weather phenomena. There's no dearth of extreme weather phenomena and novel extreme weather phenomena being constantly reported from North America, especially during this pandemic. Last weekend, the US Pacific Northwest was hit by a bout of really bad weather and severe rain, which not only caused very serious flooding events and also broke 24-hour precipitation records, both in the form of rains and snowfall, causing massive flooding at sea level areas and dumping enormous quantities of snow in many high altitude regions. Stories about this past weekend tend to mention two important weather phenomena. One is the atmospheric river and the other is a bomb cyclone, which is a misnomer, technically bombogenesis. In this video, we'll look at how both of these phenomena work and how they were at play last weekend at the US Pacific Coast. I'm Sandhya Ramesh and this is Pure Science. The Pacific Coast of the US has been under drought conditions for a while, ranging from severe to extreme drought to exceptional drought. This was then followed by a period of rains which quickly became excessive and dangerous. This was a result of a weather phenomenon known as an atmospheric river. An atmospheric river is exactly as the name sounds. It's analogous to a river in the atmosphere, which basically means extremely heavy, moisture-laden air being transported in the atmosphere. There are other names for the phenomenon, such as tropical plumes or moisture plumes. An atmospheric river consists of a strip of air that transports moisture across large distances across the globe. This strip of air is usually very narrow, and atmospheric rivers are meandering just like real rivers. Atmospheric rivers usually originate in the tropical oceans and bring extremely heavy and sustained and long periods of rainfall to the northern parts of North America and Europe. Many plumes or atmospheric rivers can and do occur simultaneously, and in fact we think that on average there's at least three plumes active at any given point in time. These plumes or atmospheric rivers are responsible for the major part of the transport of water vapor between the two hemispheres. They often lead to extreme winter showers in the northern hemisphere. One of the most well-known atmospheric rivers is the Pineapple Express. It is not a scientific term, but it is used for the large-scale flow of warm and humid air from the Hawaiian Islands along the rest of the mainland Pacific coast. These atmospheric rivers are driven by the jet stream, which we've seen are strong bands of winds high up in the atmosphere. When a cold front comes in from the Siberian region towards the North American continent, it is often called a Siberian Express. One of the parts of the world where atmospheric rivers play a key role and can be observed, studied, and monitored very easily is California. Because of the state's location and climate, there is constant variability in the atmospheric rivers or plumes occurring around the state. These atmospheric rivers typically contribute to about half the rainfall experienced by the state. And the region is also located in such a way that the effects of water use policies can actually be seen immediately with precipitation patterns. While the atmospheric river brought about record-breaking winds and record-breaking rainfall in the state, with Sunday becoming the wettest day on record for many cities in the state, in higher latitudes, precipitation occurred in the form of extremely heavy snowfall. Across many parts of the coast and a little bit to the interior, several thousands were left without power and with flooded roads and houses. What ended up causing the sudden intense rainfall after a period of sudden intense drought was a phenomenon called bombogenesis, or what we've previously discussed before in other Pure Science videos as explosive cyclogenesis. As the name suggests, explosive cyclogenesis is the genesis of a cyclone in an explosive or fast manner. The reason the storm dumped so much water and snowfall is because it underwent rapid strengthening. Most of us are familiar with how cyclones or hurricanes form and strengthen. They form over the oceans when warm air that is laden with moisture rises up from the surface of the ocean. This air cools as it climbs higher, and cooler air also rushes in to fill in the space. And this process goes on repeating. If the water surface continues to remain warm, there is a very conducive environment for rapid strengthening. So the process can expand and scale very rapidly and form a cyclone. When this process of strengthening is occurring, the air column that is rising does so faster and faster, and the pressure at the center of the storm drops lower and lower. How low the pressure drops is not indicative of how fast the storm is intensifying. How fast the pressure drops within the storm is what measures intensification. When the pressure drops drastically and quickly, the speeds of the winds intensify due to the pressure difference, and if this happens within a matter of hours, storms undergo a weather bomb or bombogenesis or explosive cyclogenesis. This is actually quite common in the Pacific and the Atlantic Oceans. When the column of air rises inside these storms, it climbs higher and cools down. But it's carrying moisture with it, which then condenses at these heights to form clouds or rain or snow or hail or any form of precipitation. And the faster the air rises and cools, the more extreme and heavy the precipitation. This typically happens in the winter, even though bombogenesis can sometimes occur with summer storms. This bomb cyclone, which is not the technically correct term for it but is still being used nonetheless, is what created the atmospheric river in the first place, pulling in moisture and warm air from the Pacific. And of course, it led to a trail of flooding, flash floods, mudslides, power outages, and destruction of infrastructure in its wake. What the intense storm and precipitation did do was to put an end to wildfires that were raging in the state. Last week, last Thursday, there were 17 wildfires in the United States, and 8 of them were then burning in California before the rains arrived. And then the rains turned out to be deadly as well. Of course, needless to say, in the immediate and near future, all these weather events are only expected to become much more extreme.